in verse 8 that he read the book clearly, distinctly, and he caused the people to understand. Alifanya watu wakaelewa. Kuna two things there. Aliwasomea Biblia alafu akawafundisha. Akafanya watu wakaelewa neno. I challenge the men and women of God in the house. Our task as ministers is to not only read God's word to God's people, but to help people make sense out of it. In Britain, they say that nothing has been learnt if nothing has been taught. I will not be a teacher if the student is not learning. I've been a victim in my teaching ministry many times. I stand up here with the things I want to teach. I have copious notes, well researched that I want to teach. And sometimes when I'm here, what puts pressure on me is to try to deliver my content. Trained teachers like me, you know that's the most terrible thing you can do to a student when you are trying to cover the syllabus. You can cover the entire syllabus and nobody learned nothing. You can cover 40 minutes of a lesson and nobody learned anything. I was a high school teacher in a school called Senior Logan in Kisumu now. Wanafunzi hawako wanafanya vyema, they were not passing. Tukaita wazazi. Ili tuongee, to discuss vile the kids can pass exams. Everyone. If your school is not doing well, never call your parents. They'll tell you the truth. They asked us, you teachers, where did you train? Did you go to a different college from the ones in Alliance? Why are those not passing and you're failing? Wakaongea. I don't remember what people said that day. Kuna mzee moja anaitwa mzee Obilo. He said something in a joke that changed my life as a teacher to date. Mzee Obilo stood up and he said, I've seen mathematics scholars in the world. Where are the mathematics teachers? And they stood in front of all parents. He said, I am not a teacher. Mathematics is bad. And I know the reason why. You have told us that you have covered the syllabus, you have taught everything. He said, you teachers, your problem in senior law is one. You are teaching mathematics. Please, stop teaching mathematics. Teach the guy. Don't teach maths. That changed my thinking on teaching. Many teachers teach English, teach English. They don't cover the syllabus. But the child has not been taught. As a teacher of the world, kama mwalimu wa neno, kazi yetu ni kufanya watu waelewe. Make the people understand. Ukisikia mwalimu anasema, mimi nimefanya kazi yangu, mwalimu ndio wajinga, wanafunzi ndio wajinga, I want to suggest huyu mwalimu pae pia ni mjinga. Kwa sababu watu wanaenda shule juu ni wajinga, si ndio? Na kazi ya mwalimu ni kufukuza ujinga. We go to school because we are fools. And the work of the teacher is to drive our foolishness and bring understanding. Make the people understand. So as God is helping me, I'm no longer bothered about I have this note, I must teach all of it. No. We may find you one point, but it is fully understood. Glory be to God. At the university, my best professor was Professor Wanaina, philosophy class, is now the Vice Chancellor of Kenyatta. He taught us philosophy. When we were down in first year to do philosophy, many other people about philosophy is a difficult one. And whenever Wanaina came, he shared one concept and he walked away. You didn't even have to write, make notes. whatever he said, you understood. You know, the best teacher we've ever had is Jesus. Nobody took notes in his crusade, but you remembered everything. When I grow up, I want to teach like Jesus, where nobody takes notes, but you remember everything. You touch your neighbor and say, Jesus. They did here. Say it again.
Jesus.
And so Ezra, if you read Ezra also, I think chapter 9, later on in your own time, the Bible says that Ezra had prepared himself to study the law, understand the law, do the law, and teach the law. The strength of a teacher is in ability to prepare. He had prepared his heart. Next time I ask you to minister, take time to prepare yourself. Even if I don't ask you, if you're in the worship team or any department, don't just walk in and do. Prepare yourself spiritually, mentally, physically. Go to the gym. So they taught the word, they explained it to the people. And they help people to understand what wakaanza kuelewa. How about the sikia neno for a long time, they never had the word. Over 70 years, they never had it. And in one day, next day, they made people to make sense out of it. I was born and brought up a Seventh-day Adventist. Mimi ni wa Adventista. Na nilikuwa na somo neno. Hata nilikuwa na fundisha neno. Lakini sikuwa nimeelewa. But I thank God for the revelation we now have in this world. The best way to learn God's word is to sit under other teachers and hear them explain the word. Today, the thing I value most in my life is sitting down, listening to other men and women explain the scriptures. Kuna ndugu, there's a man who comes on Sahara television, is called Womack. Anybody have seen that guy? I listen to that man. Every time I check Sahara, I want to hear him explain the Bible. There is another man called David Jeremiah. Before he went on TV, he was on radio, and he used to take us through the Bible, Genesis to Revelation. There is a man called John Carson. I watch him late on Family TV and on Hope. And John Harvey, other men of God. John Austin, you want to hear how they also explain the Word of God. And the teachers of the word, the scribes, walimu wa neno, walifundisha neno, wakafanya watu kuelewa the word of God. And if you want to be a great teacher, listen to other teachers. If you want to be a great soldier, walk with other generals. If you want to be a great singer, be in the company of other singers. And so they made people understand. As he taught the word, the Bible says that the people were affected. They realized they had come short of the standard of God. They showed up there and they were dying, and they had broken all the rules and all the commandments. What was that? Wakaona vile wamepungukiwa, vile wako chini, vile wamevunja sheria za Mungu. And they are reminded how God has been good to them. Vile Mungu amewasaidia na amewasahau. Now, the preachers were not trying to make the people become guilty. They only shared the word. Now God help whatever teacher who got say here, because many times, and it's not easy to escape that, unless you're an experienced Bible teacher like Esther Holt, but many times when you stand up here, many times, just wave up like that. Many times when you stand here, if you're not careful, you can choose to address a person. Na nielewa kweli? Unaposimama hapa inaweza kuwa umekosana na mtu. Alafu unatengeneza ujumbe ama unachukua hiyo ujumbe na unatumia kubonga mtu mwingine ama to settle a score. This pulpit can be used to handle people. Maybe you are offended me like Peter and he doesn't have a chance to be here. So I can't come here preaching that I'm turning the message to handle an issue with Peter. That is not easy to avoid. Because out of their heart, the mouth will speak. And that's why you should be very careful. Those who are not married, please, don't get married to a pastor. That's my wife. You are an example in church, you know. You listen to pastor like my wife always says, you know. You are an example in a fishbowl. So, if you are a wife of an elder who is soon becoming a pastor, you start interceding. But who else do you want the pastor to talk about? You are the only one he knows. And if you have a disagreement in the house in your pastor's wife, most likely they'll bring it to the pulpit and say, some women are stubborn. When a pastor talks about some women, 90% chance we know who the woman is. So, so we even use this place to settle domestic issues. And as you do that, you hope that towards the end of the service, your wife will come for the altar call and repent of all the things she has done. How many of you know these pastor wives also never really get to the altar call because they know that was not God, that was you. I'm not submitting. I'm not coming there. That was at the end of the end of the service, if she's strong enough and mature, she'll tell you, Pastor, thank you for the word, Lakini. Can you start where we left off that fight? Start what you repented. No, I just came in front for your own sake to save our family. But now, what were you talking about before we left the house? But the guys in Nehemiah, we are not using the Bible to settle personal scores. They just explain the word. Sometimes we are preaching and you begin to say, are you drunkards? And that's not in the scripture that you're reading. You remember, you started with it, and it was not in the text. We've gone out of God's word. We are not trying to convict people, which is not our job. Sometimes you do not have to address the issue you know. Maybe I know Brother X has this problem. And if I'm immature, I will organize the sermon to that direction. At that time, it's not God's word. But if we speak God's word faithfully, the Holy Spirit is able to pick that word and use it to help somebody, me, you, or your neighbor. So preachers, we really have to pray. It's a difficult thing. Secondly, those who are listening to the word. Many times, when we hear the word, sometimes you feel like I'm being targeted. Why is it just on my case? Someone told me. I get no sister, so I also talk to her. Or, at other times, you hear the word and you say, aha, thank you, Pastor. Samson needs that. I was preaching in a church and the pastor is a loud man. He doesn't know how to whisper. I don't know what I say, then I have him telling his wife, he's talking to so-and-so. Yet the mother, I really wanted to know who this so-and-so was. I found out who it was. That is what you call the big spoon, brethren. How many of you have used a spade for sand? You take the sand, you throw it the other way. You take the sand, you throw it the other way. So they are brethren like that. They chop those one. That must be for Gladys. And then that one definitely belongs to William. And yes, this one, glory to God, that's for Regina. And you are very generous distributing the word of God to everybody except yourself. I had a story of a Ndugu mmoja, one brother, hakili haikuwa timamu sana.